And President Trump is holding his daily White House COVID-19 task force briefing on Capitol Hill. So let's go live to the White House to listen.
Americans, to know that we will get through this challenge. The hardship will end. It will end soon. Normal life will return, and our economy will rebound very, very strongly. But right now, in the midst of this great national trial, Americans must remain united in purpose and focused on victory. To every single American, please know that the sacrifice you're making at this time is saving lives, many, many lives. It's very important that we totally protect our Asian American community in the United States and all around the world. They're amazing people, and the spreading of the virus is not their fault in any way, shape, or form. They're working closely with us to get rid of it. We will prevail together. It's very important. From the beginning, we have been working closely with our nation's best scientists and medical professionals, and we will continue to do so until we have defeated the virus. Our public health experts, who are terrific, are studying the variation in the disease across the country, and we will be using data to recommend new protocols to allow local economies to cautiously resume their activity at the appropriate time. We also have a large team working on what the next steps will be once the medical community gives a region the okay, meaning the okay to get going, to get back. Let's go to work. Our country wasn't built to be shut down. This is not a country that was built for this. It was not built to be shut down. My administration continues to work with Democrats and Republicans to reach an agreement on an urgent relief bill for the millions of American workers and small businesses and large businesses that were badly affected by the medical difficulty that we've had. If you had a viable business.
All right. If you would like to continue watching the news conference with President Trump, you can find it on our VNL News app. President Trump is deploying the National Guard to help fight coronavirus in New York, California, and Washington State. But healthcare workers are warning of an unfolding medical crisis, and they're begging for protective gear. NBC's Gabe Gutierrez is outside a hospital in Brooklyn, New York, with more.
Doctors and nurses coast to coast tell us the situation is critical.
In some areas, like surgical masks, we're virtually down to zero.
Despite government promises, they're desperate for protective gear and say time is running out.
We're about 10 days away from our public health system not being able to support coronavirus patients sufficiently for lack of equipment and supplies.
In New York, Governor Andrew Cuomo is asking hospitals to expand their capacity by 50%. The state is turning four sites, including the massive Javits Convention Center in Manhattan, into temporary medical facilities to deal with the expected surge of new patients. Governor Cuomo is also calling on the federal government to use the Defense Production Act to order companies to make more ventilators and masks. Right now, he says there's rampant price gouging.
There are masks that we were paying 85 cents for. We're now paying $7. Why? Because I'm competing against every other state, and in some cases, against other countries around the world.
On the front lines, healthcare workers say they're in dire need.
We just did another national survey of our nurses as of March 20th. 55% still say they don't have access to N95 respirators on their unit.
There's a fear of contagion. They're doing their best to protect themselves, but this virus is crazy contagious.
Dr. Michael Sack from Alabama is among those who have already tested positive for COVID-19.
There's a fear of being overwhelmed. Everyone's trying to do the right thing, but if we don't get control of this quickly, like in the next 2 to 3, 4 weeks, our hospital systems will be overwhelmed and our healthcare workers will be burning the candle at both ends.
President Trump says his preference is to not use the Defense Production Act because private companies are stepping up instead.
The concept of nationalizing our business is not a good concept.
GM, Ford, and Tesla are offering to help make ventilators. Apple CEO Tim Cook says the company is donating millions of masks, while Haynes says it's retrofitting some of its facilities to make them.
The 3M Corporation, which is based in Minnesota, is also stepping up, increasing its production of N95 masks to 35 million per month in the United States, 90% of which are designated for healthcare workers. A drugstore giant is embarking on its most ambitious hiring drive ever. The positions it needs to fill and the bonuses still to come.